So now that we know how to create a WebSocket server, a WebSocket client, how to run them locally, and we've also learned what glitch.com is and how can we create new projects on glitch.com that live on the cloud. So what we're going to do in this video is we're going to take the WebSocket server that we developed locally and that we could run in our own machine, and we're going to deploy it. We're going to put it online so that it's living in on the internet, and then we can all connect to this so we can all connect to this server. Okay, so the way we're going to do that is, remember, the in our project, in our Echo server, we had the package file that defines the dependencies, and we also had the main server.js file, which defines the main code that runs the main code that runs the server. So what we're going to do here is, instead of deploying the project from GitHub, which many of us may not be familiar with yet, I have not explained this in my channel, how to use Git and GitHub, etc. I will want to do a playlist around that at some point. So what we're going to do is we're going to start with a template project, like a Hello Express template project, and then we're just going to modify that so with our own code. So I'm going to start a Hello Express template, and it's going to do its thing, and it's going to give me a random name, Square Feather Antique. And I'm going to replace this name here with a custom name. So I'm going to call this simple WebSocket server echo. Okay, that's going to be the name of my project. And you're going to see that here I have the README, which I don't really need. So I'm going to delete this file. And then the views and the public folders, those were also folders that were coming from the Express server. So I don't really need those, so I'm going to delete them. And then I also want to open here the logs window so that I can see what's going on behind the hood in my application. And then I'm going to dock this to the right, and then I'm going to have my old code, the one that was local, and my server code side by side. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to take all this code, the code that was running on the server, and I'm going to overwrite whatever was in the template with that code. So this is my server code, okay? And right now you can see that if I look at the logs, it's given me a bunch of errors. And if we look here, it says I cannot find module WS. So it cannot find this. That is because we have not yet modified package.json, which, remember, is the file that defines the dependencies. And in this file, we have a dependency, which is the Express module, which was coming with the template and we don't need anymore. But what we're going to do is we're going to replace that with the real dependency that we have here, which is the WebSocket library. So I'm going to write here the WebSocket and the version. And as I go down, you can see that things have changed. And now node is installing, etc., etc., and things are going. And voila, we have this message here, which is the server is listening on port 5000. Okay, so this is a really good sign. So let's see if this works. So what I'm going to do now is I am going to try to connect with one of the clients that I had before. So I'm going to go to client simple, and I'm going to open here a PowerShell, and then I'm going to say node client. But if I do this, it's not going to connect to anything, all right? Because if you remember, let me drop the client server, let me drop it into code, Visual Studio Code. If you remember, we had specified for our client that the connection address needed to be on the local machine. So it needed to be the local host, this 127.127.0.0.1. Now, this is not the case anymore because the server that we want to connect to is not living on our machine, it's living somewhere on the cloud. So what do I need to replace this with? So what I need to do is I need to say co server address needs to be, in this case, a new server that is going to be whatever this thing is living. And whatever this thing is living is going to be the name of the, so it's going to be WSS, and I believe we're going to be doing double SS because glitch.com requires secure connection, so that's one thing. So we're going to type here the name of the server, .glitch.me, all right? And then we're going to, and then that's going to be it. We don't need to specify the port for in this case. So let's see if that works. So I'm going to dock this here. Oops. All right. So I'm going to dock this here somewhere, and then I'm going to clear the screen and I'm going to try to connect again. All right. And now I am getting this one error, which is that it cannot connect because the server is responding with this weird error message, which is 502. 502 is bad gateway response. We don't really need to get into the weeds of why that is. And the bottom line is that glitch.com has a special security feature that doesn't really allow anyone who wants to ping a particular service, like a WebSocket service, doesn't allow anyone in the wild to do it, because then it would be prone to DDoS attacks and like servers would overload, etc. So some of the safety features in glitch.com, and this is very specific to glitch.com, it is that what incoming WebSocket clients need to have an user agent specified. Okay, again, this is a very, very glitch.com thing. And the way to do that is by adding a particular here when we create the WebSocket client on our end. Something that we need to do is we need to specify not only the address that we need to connect to, but we also need to specify here some data that needs to be attached with the connection. And that data is that some options that we need to specify for this connection. Those options are going to be that the headers need to incorporate a specific rule, which is going to be that the user agent needs to be something. So for example, custom WebSocket client, it doesn't really matter, but there needs to be an user agent. And actually, if you want, I'm not sure if this needs to be lowercase or uppercase. If you want, you can basically try to trick glitch.com and just write right here Mozilla, or write Google Chrome, or whatever this is. User agent basically specifies what type of browser, typically, or what kind of software is running this this request. So I'm going to save this, and I'm going to clear the screen, and I'm going to try to connect again to the server. And as I do this now, you can see that now I was able to connect, and then the server received a message from this client, hello server, and then that message was sent back to my client, which was here, someone said, hello server. What's beautiful, again, about this is that now I can open another PowerShell, I can have another service here, and I'm going to move this all the way up here, I can have another service, and I can use this to connect to run the client as well. And if as I run the client, I'm going to connect to the server, I'm going to send a message, and it's going to be broadcasted to this guy and this guy. So I'm going to do that. I sent it here, and then this one, it was blocked, but yeah, it also received the call. And I can start even a third one, right? Which I got here, and then node client, you see? And then the server receives the response, and then it broadcasts this message to all the clients. All right? So yoo-hoo! So now this server is living on the cloud. And actually, I believe for the sake of this video, I'm just going to leave this project living here forever. So, and I'm not going to touch it. So if you're watching this video in the future, hopefully this simple WebSocket Server Echo project is still living and is still online. However, remember that glitch.com puts processes to sleep after 30 minutes of inactivity. So whenever you are watching this video and you write this and you try to connect, maybe the first time you connect, it may take a minute or two for the server to wake up and to serve a response, okay? But yeah, so that was it. So we have now a server that is living on the cloud, and we can connect from any local server, any local client, and exchange information. So I think right now we are in a very good position to now start experimenting with exchanging richer information, not just simple hello messages, and use that information to inform how clients can communicate with each other and what they can share between each other. So I think I have in mind an example where we're going to create a canvas with a circle, and then we're going to move the circle, and we're going to have that circle move around all the different clients on the screen. Okay? So how about that? Should we try that? Let's do this. Let's move on to the next video and do some circle synchronization between different clients. Okay? Let's check it out.